Hey everyone, I'm Shaylin here with Reedsy. Today we're going to be talking about some common writing tips that I don't agree with. Number one, this is a common one. You've probably heard this writing tip all the time. Write every day. Now, there's nothing wrong with writing every day. A lot of people swear by it, and it does work for a lot of people. I've gone through pretty long periods of my life where I've written every day or almost every day. As kind of a baseline rule, I just don't think it's a very good one, because it just doesn't work for a lot of people. Sure, lots of people swear by it, but just because one person swears by it doesn't mean it's gonna work for everyone. I know a lot of writers who much prefer to write only a few days of the week, but for a really long time. So they would rather sit down and just smash out several thousand words 3 times a week than trying to write a little bit every day. And that's just what works for them. If you're forcing yourself to write every day when it doesn't work for you, you can risk burnout, and that's never fun. Number two, dialogue should be realistic. Now, of course, that sounds like it makes sense, but really, dialogue should sound natural, but it shouldn't necessarily be realistic. If you were to ever read an exact transcript of a conversation between actual speaking humans, it would not make good dialogue. People trail off, a lot of people talking over each other. Good dialogue is like if you took that transcript of a real conversation and edited it, so it was much more concise and made much more sense. You want your dialogue to sound natural, but it shouldn't be an exact transcript of realistic dialogue. Number three, everything should be foreshadowed. Now, nothing wrong with a little bit of foreshadowing, but you don't have to foreshadow everything in your book. Foreshadowing is really great if you have a twist that kind of comes out of nowhere. Foreshadowing can be a fun device to use, but you don't need to foreshadow everything that happens in your book. If something happens in your book and it's fairly logical, it's just a fairly logical advancement of the plot, you don't need to foreshadow that because it's set up by just the logic of the situation. It's great to foreshadow things that defy the logic of the situation, but if the events are kind of just happening logically, that doesn't necessarily mean predictable, but just logical, you don't really need to foreshadow that. Number four, here's a big one, write what you know. Now, nothing wrong with writing about what you know, nothing wrong with writing from your life experiences and the topics you know well, but I also don't think there's any reason to confine yourself to that. It is important to do your research. As some people say, know what you write. Once I was writing a TV pilot for school, and the main character of my TV pilot was a forensic scientist, and I am in no way a forensic scientist. I have not done math in so long, and I hope to never do it again. But I still wrote the screenplay. It took a lot of research, it was really hard, but it was what I wanted to write, and I really enjoyed writing it. So, no reason to be confined to writing about what you know. Number five, never use the word said. This is writing advice that's been floating out for a long time. I think a lot of people have kind of debunked it at this point, but it's one that really grinds my gears. I was taught to never use the word said all through school. It was said is dead. As they said. Said is a great word. I would recommend using said for almost all of your dialogue tags. Probably at least 90% of your dialogue tags actually should be the word said. Said functions more as a form of punctuation. It's like a comma. We don't really notice it. We don't really hear its repetition. Using said lets the dialogue kind of just speak for itself rather than trying to explain your dialogue through different dialogue tags. Number six, never use passive voice or fragments. Now, it is really good to avoid passive voice. Passive voice can really weaken your writing, but there are actually a lot of cases where you really need passive voice. So for example, if I was writing the sentence, the university was built 50 years ago. This is in passive voice, and the reason we have to use passive voice is because the people who did the action, the building, we don't know who they are. So to rephrase that and make it active, we would have to add a subject and say something like, engineers built the university 50 years ago, but that doesn't really matter. We don't really need to know that. We can just say the university was built 50 years ago. That's what the sentence needs. Cut passive voice where you can, but there are cases where you kind of need it and where it's not really an issue. Similarly with sentence fragments. Sentence fragments, I know some writers always avoid them. Personally, I think that it's fine to use sentence fragments. I think a one-word sentence timed well can have a lot of impact on your writing. If used sparingly and used properly and used purposefully, can add a nice punch. You know, if you're using them, if you're overusing them, it can be a problem. If you're using them accidentally and just accidentally having sentences that are fragments and they just read awkwardly, that's a problem. But I don't think they have to be avoided 100% of the time. And finally, number seven, take a break after the first draft. Now, this definitely works for some people. This is one of those things where if it works for you, that's great, but I just don't think it works for everyone. It's kind of common advice to say that when you're done the first draft, you should leave it before you try to edit it. But I find for myself, editing as soon as I'm done the first draft is the best time to edit. That's when the story feels the most malleable, I'm the most excited to edit it. The longer I let it sit, the more it kind of feels like it freezes into place and it's harder to edit. So if it works for you, that's great to take a break, but for some people, like myself, I find it's best to just jump into my edits immediately. So those are 7 common writing tips that I don't really agree with. What is the most common writing tip that you don't like? Let me know in the comments. Thank you so much for watching, and remember to subscribe for new writing, editing, and publishing videos every Tuesday and Friday. Until next time.